God. Praise God.
Amen.
It is not a man, but it is God. Amen.
Amen.
I would like you to have your seat. I'm grateful about Papa, about God, about Papa. Amen.
Amen.
For that trust every day to me as the Son. Amen. And I'm happy to have you tonight. I'm happy also to have one of my daughter. She loves me a lot. She's here.
Amen.
She's always very amazed when I'm preaching. Amen.
Amen.
And when I look at her, it encouraged me a lot again. To atena, rem atena. Amen.
Amen.
And she, I'm paying the sound. You know, she has that accent.
Uh-huh.
And she say, mercy, mercy, the rain, the rain. You see? Ay, 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 ay. Amen. Amen. I'm proud of one of my daughter again in the choir or worship team. Worship team. She's improving day by day. Can we just appreciate God for what He's doing in their life? Amen. Today I'm going to talk to you about the mystery of God. Can you say to your neighbor, mystery of God?
Mystery of God.
One more time, mystery of God.
Mystery of God.
Okay, I understand. Amen. Firstly, I would like you to open your Bible in the book of Mark, chapter 5, verse 21 to 40. Today we're going to read the Bible.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
We have to know the Bible. Yes. Amen.
Amen.
Mark chapter 1. Sorry. Mark chapter 5, 21 to 43. Yes. Amen.
Amen.
But before that, I would like to tell you something. In Genesis 17, isn't it? Can you give me Genesis 17. I love you forever. I love you forever. I love you forevermore. Isn't it? About prophecy. But also, just there. Prophecy, it is a seed. Are you getting me? It is a word of seed meant in your life. Are you getting me? Prophecy, it is a seed spoken or speak into your life and your generation. Are you understand? When I say you will be the manager, you get it? The word is addressed to you. But in future, you will realize not only you who will be the manager, that word will follow even your sister. You get me? You will understand that even your children, one of them will become a manager. You understand? The prophecy, it is a seed established in your life and even after you, the generation after you. You get me? That's why you will see God spoke to Abraham, I will multiply your greatly. See you? I will multiply you greatly, or I will make you a father of nation. Isn't it? That word was addressed to Abraham, but all of a sudden, Abraham did not become great. Isn't it? Who became great? The third generation after him.
Yes.
Yeah? The Bible says, I will make you the father of the nation. Currently, Abraham personally did not become a father of the nation. He got Isaac, isn't it? The prophetic word was from him, isn't it? No, sorry. The prophetic word from was to him, see, isn't it? Upon him, I will make you the father of a nation. But all of a sudden, those nation came to pass in his third generation, isn't it? That means that prophetic word was a seed. Are you getting me? That prophetic word was a seed into his generation. Are you getting me? When he got Isaac, he was still not a nation, isn't it? But the word was there. Amen. When Isaac got Jacob, when Jacob got 12, that is when the story started. You understand? But the word was addressed to Abraham. And the word came to pass to his third generation. Look, whatever you are receiving, it is a seed.
Amen.
Are you getting me? Whatever you are receiving, it is a seed. It will affect you. It will affect even the generation after you. That's why I would like to challenge somebody. Do not accept any evil word upon your life. Because it might affect even the generation after you. Are you getting me? God spoke to Abraham, I will make you a multitude. I will make you a father of the nation. And it came to pass. The Bible says, life and death belong to the power of tongue. And the one who speak it eats the fruit of their tongue. That means, whatever you speak has an authority. Amen. When you receive a prophetic word, thank God. Know that that word will affect, will follow even my house, even the children of my children. But when somebody speak a negative word, break it immediately. Are you getting me? When you are hearing a spoken curses upon your life, your family, break it. Because the Bible says, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. And any time. Now pia, you bring to him when he's coming with a negative tongue against you, you go take him also, say Proverbs 18:23. Do not say, no, what? Amen. Are you getting my point? Tonight is the night of revelation. Amen. The mystery of God. Amen. I would like you to, someone to read Mark 5:21. Are you hearing my accent? 21 to 43. 40. Amen. Of course, we are international. I'm tired of accents. Allow me. Kisi accent. I'm tired of it. I'm tired of it. English, American. Open with me. Mark chapter 5. 21:43.
Water.
Amen. Yes. We have the dimension of water. We have the dimension of mercy. We have the dimension of learning.
Yes.
Not when I English, when I say I put headache. No. Here we are entering the dimension, even our accent. You feel that belong to ARC, just the accent. I say, come on, welcome.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
We are a civilized church, isn't it?
Yes.
Hey, we are not such a church for people who came from Shako.
Yes.
Yeah? Yes. Of course, I'm a Congolese, you are a Kenya. There is people from Cameroon, people from Gabon, people from, isn't it? International church, and when you speak, people must hear excellence,
yes,
from your mouth.
Yes.
Didn't you? Excellence English. Even if you come from Ushago, high school Ushago, you bought Ushago, but when you are here, you will be transformed.
Amen.
Look, anointing transforms everything,
yes,
even your mind, even your accent, even the way you look, even the way you. Endelee. Wacha tuniache. Tusome Biblia. Okay, can we read together?
When Jesus.
Loudly.
When Jesus had crossed over again by the road to the other side, a large crowd gathered around him and was invited by the Spirit.
Quickly also.
One of the men of the Jesus came and as he saw Jesus.
Please, Jairus, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay. I would like you to. Okay, Jairus, isn't it?
Yes.
Don't forget that name.
I will.
Let's continue.
And said to him, my little daughter is at death's door. Come and lay your hands on her so she can get well and live. So Jesus went with him, and a large crowd was following and pressing against him. A woman suffering from I endured much and had many doctors. She had spent everything she had and was not helped at all. On the contrary, she from the synagogue leaders' house to say, "Your daughter is dead. Why bother the teacher anymore?"
It's over.
But when Jesus overheard what to say, he told the synagogue leader, "Don't be afraid, only believe." He did not let anyone accompany him except Peter, James, and John, James' brother. They came to the leader's house, and he saw a commotion. People were weeping and weeping about it. He went in and said to them, "Why are you making a commotion and weeping? The child is not dead, but asleep." They started laughing at him, but he put them all outside. He took the child's father, mother, and those who were with him, and entered the place where the child was. Then he took the child by the hand and said to her, "Talitha kum," which is translated, "Little girl, I say to you, immediately the girl got up and began to walk. She was 12 years old, and these were utterly astounded. Then he gave them three orders, and one had to know about this, and say that she should be prepared went away from there and came to his hometown, and his disciples followed him.
Amen. Amen. Bring to me Mark 5:21. Tell your neighbor, mystery of God.
Mystery of God.
Again, one more time, mystery of God.
Mystery of God.
I'm going to talk to you about three people here. Isn't it? I told you, as you just read, about Jairus, isn't it? Mm-hmm. About the daughter, yes. Jairus, and the lady with issue of blood. Okay. Jairus was like an intercessor to the daughter, isn't it? Who was suffering for 12 years old, isn't it? And the lady with issues of blood, isn't it? Was suffering for 12 years. Isn't it?
Yes.
Okay. Jairus was the father to the daughter. Isn't it? When Jairus heard about Jesus, isn't it? He followed Jesus. Isn't it? Because he had a problem. Did you? He had a challenge in his home. Amen. Her daughter was suffering. "Master, come, my daughter is about to die. Come and lay your hand on her and she will live." Isn't it? In another way, I can say Jairus was an intercessor, isn't it? For the daughter. So that the daughter will not die. Isn't it? She will live. Amen.
Amen.
But in real life, if you read well this verse, you will understand that because of Jairus' intercessory, isn't it? Because of Jairus' prayer, because of Jairus' interceding, that's why even the lady with the issues of blood was healed. Are you hearing me? Because without the Jairus, to leave his home and follow Jesus and kneel down and ask Jesus to come, without Jairus, if Jairus could have not that action, the lady with that issue of blood could have not met Jesus. Are you hearing my point? Jairus, come before Jesus. Jesus, come, please help my daughter. She's about to die. Jesus said, okay, let go. Are you hearing me? In another way, Jairus was interceding, isn't it, for the daughter. But when Jesus was going on his way to Jairus' house, can somebody say when he was going?
When he was going?
When he was going to Jairus' house, Jesus met with the lady who had blood issue. Are you hearing my point? That means the intercessory of Jairus, isn't it, met Jesus with the lady. Are you hearing me? I would like to tell somebody, you are an intercessor.
Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Your prayer, your prayer, so many people, you are the pillar of so many people. Are you hearing me? You are the foundation of so many people. You are the head to whom people depend according to your prayer. Are you hearing me? Because if Jairus could not go to Jesus, the lady could have not met with Jesus. Are you hearing me? But Jairus, maybe he knew that there is more challenges than mine. Let me go to Jesus. Let me intercede. Let me beg Jesus so that my daughter and other people shall receive their breakthrough. Are you hearing my point? I'd like to tell somebody, what you are doing here, what you are doing in your house, it is not only for you and your family. Are you getting my point?
Yes.
Your prayer affecting even your neighbor. Are you hearing my point? Your prayer is touching even people from US without knowing. Are you getting my point? Your prayer has value before God. When you are interceding here for 1 hour, you say, God, give me joy. But God is seeing beyond that joy. God is hearing another prayer request through you. Eh? You are the head. Because without Jairus' prayer, that lady could have not been healed. Even if you had the faith, but there is always a pillar to connect you to what you need. Are you getting my point? Jairus, Jesus, and the lady. Eh? Always three people before you break through. You're not hearing me. God work in Trinity. God work in complementary. Are you hearing me? Before God to work a miracle upon your life, he will pass to somebody. You get it? Before God to do anything upon your life, he will pass through someone. Before the lady to get healed, Jairus came, connected with Jesus, and Jesus connected with the lady. Are you hearing me? Because if the breakthrough comes just all of a sudden, you will take that breakthrough for your glory.
Yes.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Before me to come here in ARC, I had connected with Prophet John Baptist. And then Baptist connected me in ARC with Apostle Paul here. Oh, are you hearing me? The way of God is not your way. You have been praying here, I need breakthrough. Listen, after praying, let God work. He is the one who will create the way so that you reach or you get what you need. Eh? Israel was delivered by Moses, Aaron, and Miriam. Three people. Are you getting my point? Jesus was in Trinity. the children. Are you getting my point? Always Jesus work in a group, in unity. That is his nature. But I'm about to tell somebody. Jairus was begging Jesus, come help my children because he's about to die. Yeah? Jesus moved. When he was going on his way to Jairus' house, people from his house come to tell Jairus, stop troubling the master because the daughter is already done. And Jesus said, do not be afraid, just believe. I would like to tell somebody, you are here an intercessor. The intercessor has the people, the most people be to be the most people to be discouraged are the intercessors. Are you hearing me? You have been praying for someone. You have been praying for a certain situation. But all of a sudden, you are the first one who will be tempted. You are the first person who will be discouraged. Are you hearing me? You have been praying for your family. You have been praying for certain people, for somebody, for a group, whatever, I don't know. Someone gets a job and all. Look, the devil will target you, the first person to discourage. Imagine Jairus left his job. Follow Jesus. Jesus, I beg you, come and heal my children. But on his way, even before to reach in the house, people from his own house came and said, don't disturb the masters. What a two your story in the Isha. Where were and the layer curious story again? Because ume fail. Unalewa. What a two. Ume. You are looking for job. Before to reach the job, they tell you, look, hautapata hiyo job. Wewe tu rudi nyumbani, rest na fikiria biashara nyingine. Are you hearing me? Intercessors are the first person to be attacked by the spirit of discouragement. Look, as you are the pillar of your family, of I don't know whatever, you will be the first target of devil to discourage you. Because the life of so many was depending from Jairus. That's why the devil was targeting him to discourage him. So that Jesus will not put light, restoration in Jairus' house. But I'm about to tell somebody, the good news is, people will discourage you, but Jesus will be there to hold your hand. Because when Jesus heard that word of discouragement, he said to Jairus, don't be afraid, just be encouraged. I'm about to tell somebody, even if something is going wrong, people are discouraging you, look, go to the word of God. Go to the word of God. The Bible says, I will restore you. I will create the way on the wilderness. I'm about to tell somebody, even if you are here, you are faith. I'm about to tell somebody, God is a God of restoration.
Amen.
Are you hearing my point? People, the first people who will discourage you shall come from your family. They will be the nearest people in your life. Are you hearing me? Oh my God. The people who will discourage you will not come from US, will not come from Congo, will never come from Canada, never come from Kisii, never come from Muranga. They will come from your area. Imagine, people from his house came, isn't it? People who were eating with them, isn't it? You are sharing your vision. You are sharing your life, isn't it? You are sharing everything. They come to discourage you. But I'm about to tell somebody, you have to locate to who to ask. associate with it. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Do not just choose friends. Do not feel to what you doing to good. No. I want to tell somebody, who is your friend? Your friend is that person who will tell you it will be well. Even if you are going through fire, choose that friend who will tell you, don't fear, don't be discouraged, it will be well. Are you hearing me? Do not have such an environment when things are not good, they are telling you, just forget about it. Are you hearing me? Jesus was an encouragement to Jairus. He told Jairus, don't fear. Just have a faith. The enemy to your next level will not come so far. He's around you. Who betrayed Jesus? Peter. Sorry. Who betrayed Jesus? Judas. Another one was who? Peter. Who was Peter? Who was Judas? Around him, eating with him, sleeping together, sharing the vision together. Look, do not trust people. Trust only God. The devil can use anyone to discourage you. Are you hearing me? I'm about to tell somebody, even if your relationship did not succeed, it will succeed. Even if you are here, you have lost something precious. I'm about to tell you, you are about to recover.
Amen.
I'm going to tell somebody, if you are here, you went through pain and hard time, God is about to change that image. God is about to restore the same thing. You get it in a double portion.
Amen.
Because the daughter died. Isn't it? But when Jesus entered to his house, the daughter was resurrected.
Amen.
I'm about to tell somebody, what has been dead in your life shall be resurrected.
Amen.
Look, who got you because it came to pass, because it is finished, so that automatically it is end. It is not end. God is a God of resurrection. If you have lost so many money, you will recover double.
Amen.
Are you hearing me? If Jairus lost her daughter, let me tell you, Jairus knew there is a resurrection. I'm about to tell somebody, you are about to resurrect.
Yes.
You're not hearing me. You are about to resurrect. Because Jesus did not heal on the cross. Jesus was resurrected. Your level, it is not healing. Are you hearing my point? Your level, it is not healing. Your level is resurrection. Oh my God. Oh. Are you hearing my point? Your level, it is resurrection, not healing, not restoration, not establishment, not peace, but resurrection. Are you hearing my point? Resurrection is a double portion than healing. What God wants to you is only resurrection, so that the glory of God shall be manifested on what you are praying for. Are you getting my point? The lady was looking for resurrection. Eh? But you, it is not the same case. God wants, the lady was looking for healing. But you, God is seeing resurrection in your problem.
Yes.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
The lady was suffering for 12 years with blood issue, isn't it? And the daughter of Jairus was 12 years old. Almost the same thing, isn't it? 12. In a tough situation. But let me tell you, your ears, it is not the ears of God. Your thought, it is not the thought of God. The way you are thinking, it is not the same way God is thinking about your challenge. Are you hearing me? You, my God. But God is seeing a divine miracle. You want God to create a way for you, but God wants to create a divine connection upon your life. Are you hearing me? Jairus was expecting healing, but Jesus was seeing resurrection. Oh, tonight it is a night of resurrection. Look, who told you? Because your neighbor is doing well before you, so that you will not succeed.
Come back.
He will come back.
Yes.
Who told good relationship. That's a liar. God is a God of... Oh my God. God is a God of resurrection. God is gonna resurrect everything what was dying in your life. This is a year of resurrection. Because he left you so that it is over. It is not over. You are about to manifest the resurrection of God.
Yay.
People before house giants, when they saw Jesus, they said, Jesus asked them, why are you crying? They said, because the giant is dead. And Jesus told them, he's not dying, he's sleeping. Look, do not confess what you are going through. Be a man of revelation. Are you hearing me? Be a man of brethren. Oh my God. When people are sick, when people are crying, when people are saying it is over, when people are saying, me, I've just given up about betting. Me, I will not yet get married. Me, I will not yet succeed. For me, it is over. Let me tell you, when you say it is over, it is when God wants to resurrect things upon your life. People are crying outside, but Jesus was seen a sleeper than a dying person. Are you hearing me? It is not over. God is about to bring you his power. Therefore, you have to work with people who sharing the same faith, the same vision with you. And those people who can tell you it will be well. Before Jesus to enter, are you hearing me? Before Jesus to enter into Jairus' house, he stopped everyone behind him. He took with him Peter, James, and John, and the father and the mother to the daughter, and they entered in the house. Why he left everyone behind and took his disciple and the mother and the father? Because those people were sharing the same faith with Jesus. Are you hearing me? If you want to go far, if you want to succeed on your vision, if you want to see the hand of God, select those people who will encourage you. Select those people who will share the same vision with you. Select those people who will hold your vision. No matter the situation, those people will say, Chloe, mimi sikuache. Kubaya ama kuzuri, mimi sikuache. Kufa ama life, I will be with you. So many people have given up because of hearing negative voice from other people. Am I talking to somebody? Yeah? Are you hearing my point? The Bible says, faith comes from what we hear, and what we hear comes from the word of God. Isn't it? Now, what have you given to your eyes? Okay, ears. Thank you. What did you give to your ears? You become what you hear. You become what you see. If Jesus was still hearing people from Jairus' house, do not disabilize the master. The daughter is dying. Jesus could have not resurrected the girl. Because faith comes from what we hear. You are here, maybe you have stopped. Your life is stagnation, is in circle. Because of hearing others' voices, negative voice. Because you did not succeed in what you have been doing, then you gave your eyes negative voices. They told you it is over. The Lord, she has already died. Stop praying because you will not succeed in that area. Marriage si yako tena. School si yako tena. Hiyo biashara si yako tena. Wewe tu ni hospital and hospital. You will not heal. And you get all of those words. That's why everything is stagnated. I told you, faith is hearing. We become what we hear. Are you hearing me? Are you here tonight? Look, connect yourself with Jairus' house. Connect yourself with Jesus. Are you hearing me? Connect yourself with Jesus, because something is about to happen. This is a night of disconnection and connection. Eh? Jairus' house, Jairus' chamber, it is a dimension where God wants to bring you. Because in that chamber, the miracle will happen. Now, before you enter to a new dimension, to a dimension of divine connection, to a dimension of to another dimension, God wants you to select who to leave and who to enter into a new season. Are you hearing me? A season of miracle, a season of resurrection, a season of sign and wonder, a season of mystery. But God is telling you, leave behind certain people. Select from those people for you to enter the new season. Because that lady resurrected with new people. Eh? Are you hearing me? That lady, when she opened her eyes, she saw Jesus, Peter, John, and John, and James. Where is Auntie? Where is Uncle Joronjo? Where is Karaoke? Where is Nani? Where is Elijah? Those were outside of the house, because in the season of resurrection, you must enter with a new people. Are you hearing me? Eh? Because in your new season, in a season of resurrection, in a season of miracle, in a season where you are about to start a new beginning, you have to enter with another people. Eh? Adam Jorojo. Eh? Adam Matiangi. Tafuta, the one who carried the same vision with you. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
It is your season. God is about to resurrect something in you. But you are about to select. Disconnect yourself so that you connect with those people who will bring you where you're supposed to go. Look, me, I always say, I have never failed. Eh? Me, I have never failed. Hey, I have never and I will never fail.
Yes.
If you are here, you say I failed. You shall hear me. I have never failed. If things are becoming tough, I say you are about to glorify your name.
Yes.
Never say, oh no. Say, God, it is for your glory. Jairus, even he had that word. Your daughter is dying. He did not confessing that time. As you see in the Bible, Jairus said, okay, my daughter is dying. No. What he was saying, what he was doing, he was still holding the head of Jesus. Because you know, Jesus had something. Oh my God. Because Jesus had something beyond that time. I'm about to tell somebody. You are about to see a new thing.
Amen.
You are about to see the mystery of God, what you have never seen again.
Amen.
You are about to see what you have never thought.
Yes.
The Bible says the world is waiting to see. To see what? Of the Son of God. Because the world was full of corruption. Death is corruption. Discouragement is corruption. Failure is corruption. Barrenness is corruption. Now, God is about to manifest. Oh my God. God is about to manifest his power.
Yes.
Only you have to select who will bring you to that season of power. Eh? I thank God. Because ARC, we are a church. We don't bring here announcement of barren people. Eh? We are a church who demonstrates God. Hey, we can never announcement. Anti Wairimu alikufa tarehe moja. We are about, oh my God, we are a church who say healing service next Sunday.
Amen.
God will help people.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus,
Amen.
Rise and walk.
Amen.
It is your season. Look, rise and walk.
Amen.
Oh, I'm about to tell somebody, rise and walk.
Amen.
Because your season has reached,
Amen.
You are about to testify. Here.
Yes.
It is your night.
Amen.
It is a night where God wants to manifest a new thing upon your life.
Amen.
The Bible says in the book of Haggai, Haggai chapter 2 verse 9, that the second glory is glorious than the first one.
Amen.
Oh, if the first glory it is not, oh my God. If the first glory it is, oh my God. I'm not even about to move in a sour between you. If in the first glory it is, oh my God. Oh my God, oh my God. If in the first glory it did not work as you want, the second glory is coming with a new level. You are about to see what you have never seen. Am I talking to a Jairus here? Am I talking to a daughter Jairus? You are about to come back. You are about to come back.
Amen.
They say you have died, isn't it? But they did not know that you was in a season of rest. Because Dora Jairus, people will say she has already died. But Jesus was seeing the lady resting. Look, a seed, you will not kill a seed. A seed will never die. A seed will go into a soil. See you? A seed must, okay. A seed, you will not kill a seed. A seed will never die. A seed will only be barren. Isn't it? Rest under the soil to be barren, to be covered. Silence for a moment. Because a seed, because that seed is about to germinate. Eh?
Yes.
Jairus' daughter was like a seed. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
He was in a resting place. Are you hearing me? He was in a resting place. She was resting. She was in that place where she did not want any obstacle. Because she's resting. Because her double portion was about to manifest. So people got revelation. Was saying, she has already died. But Jesus was seen. Jairus' daughter has seen. He said, No. The seed, she's on her resting time. She's about to come out. She's about to germinate. I'm about to tell you, you have not yet died. You have not yet died. You haven't yet died. Are you hearing me? You are in your resting season. Oh my God. You are resting. Eh? You are resting. You are resting. God is about to bring you out of that grave. God is about to bring you out of that ground. Like the Dora Jairus. Let people talk evil about you. She has already died. It is finished about her. Let her just go and drop her to the grave because she's already finished. I'm about to tell somebody. The world is about to talk about your story. Because what will come out of you as a seed will be a testimony. They will talk about it forever and forever. That Dora, we talk about that until today. But those people who are talking, she has already died. We don't even one of them, isn't it? Let me tell you, accept to be humiliated. Accept people gossiping. Accept negative one. Because God is going to turn around things on your behalf.
Yeah.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Tonight, it is a night where I want to demonstrate the mystery of God upon your life. What the meaning of mystery? Mystery means beyond the understanding of a human being. Are you hearing me? That is the mystery. What God is about to do upon your life, it is a mystery. Just beyond the understanding of a human being. Are you hearing me? You have been saying, maybe the day is going. Anyone is doing what they want. Why think I know what is on my behalf? Why only me I'm still stagnated in the same situation? Why only that man left me? Why only I'm not be appreciated? Why men are not coming to me? Why I'm not getting better job? Why I'm still stagnated? Why rejection? Why only me? Let me tell you. You are about to see the mystery of God beyond the understanding of a human being. When people will be questioning you, how is that happening? You say, I don't know. You are about to enter into a season where you will be saying, I even don't know. Are you hearing me? I don't know. I don't know. Who hit you? I don't know him. He just told me, rise and walk. But who? I don't know. Let me tell you, you are about, your testimony will reach in that point we shall not be able to understand. Are you getting me? Because there is a divine miracle coming on your way. You know, people was asking Jairus, how that your daughter, we took her to the hospital and the doctor said she has already died. Why after 2 hours she came in life? Jairus, I think he was saying, I even don't know. I just met Jesus and Jesus spoke, rise. We are entering into a dimension where you will not be understanding what is happening in your life. Maybe when that lady with the blood of issues, isn't it? With the blood of issues, isn't it? Issue of blood. When she was healed, she was happy and went back home happy. Maybe Jairus was discouraged. Jesus, you were coming to my house, but why you engage yourself to do so many miracles? You could have just come strictly in my house and heal my daughter. Now see, because of you, maybe Jairus started to condemn Jesus, to judge Jesus. Because of you, Jesus, my daughter died. Because if you came strictly in my house, maybe she could have not died. I'm about to tell somebody, do not judge God. Yeah. Are you hearing me? Do not judge Jehovah Shammah. Do not judge Jehovah Elohim. Do not judge Jehovah El Shaddai. They told Moses, he said, I am that I am. You might be here, maybe. God, if you did it for me, I could have not been where I am. Let me tell you, the Bible says your thought is not my thought. I know why it's taking long. Because you are about to see the mystery. Are you hearing me? Do you need healing or do you need resurrection? Resurrection. Mystery. We are entering a season of mystery. When I was rejected, I was God. You told me, you will elevate me in this country. You will use me. Doesn't matter what happened. I know your word shall come to pass upon my life. I am where I am here. I am who I am here. Because I am born on the word of God. I did not look at those rejection, those treatments. I look at the word of God, because into the word of God come resurrection. Into the word of God come mystery. Into the word of God come the unbelievable thing. Are you hearing me? I'm about to finish. The Bible says in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 12 verse 9, my grace is sufficient. My strength is made to you when you are weak. Are you hearing me? My grace is sufficient to you. My strength or my power is demonstrated to you when you are weak. Let me tell you, I'm finishing here. That lady who was suffering about hemorrhage, isn't it? She knew that I'm a weak. Because I'm sick, isn't it? I'm bleeding. Jesus is the grace. For his power to be manifested in my life, I have to follow him. Because me, I'm weak, isn't it? Physically, I'm weak. Jesus is the grace. And the power and the strength is the solution, is my healing. Are you hearing me? So that, she said, even if I touch only his garment, I will be healed. Because he's my healing. Because he's my breakthrough. Because he's my power. Because my healing shall come from him. Look, that lady was healed not only because of her faith. Because she understood that Jesus is all what I want. Jesus is sufficient for me. Let me follow him. Because me, I'm weak, I'm bleeding. Let me follow the person who is not bleeding. Aye, 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 aye. Let me follow the person who is not bleeding. Because he's not bleeding if I touch his garment. Because his garment is not bleeding if I touch his garment, I will be like his garment. Then I will not bleed. I will be healed. I'm not to tell somebody, follow Jesus. Follow the one who is not bleeding. The Bible said she was suffering, giving everything to the doctor, but nothing was getting better. When you try to find solution from your strength, is that moment you start. But when you turn, you say, Jesus, you are my healer. Jesus, your grace is sufficient to me. Let me stop all of those efforts. Let me stop all of those sacrifices. Let me follow my healer. Let me follow the one who carry my solution. Let me tell you, the breakthrough will start when you turn to follow Jesus. Because he's all what you want. He's all what you need. Tonight, I'm about to tell somebody, stop hearing negative voices. Stop hearing curses. Stop disconnect yourself with unfaithful people. Like Jairus' people. Like Jairus' family. Connect yourself with Jesus, who said, if you believe, you will see the glory of God. Enough is enough. Malakaya basata la basata. I am a Jairus tonight. I want to see the hand of God. Yes, everything is down, but I know you are a God of resurrection. Malakaya basata la basita. Palakia basita la basita. Negra la basata la basita. Negra la basata la basata. Ma queremo santa la basita. Ma queremo la basata la basata la basata. Paria basata la basita. Riga la basata la basata la basata. Le credemo santa la basata. Everyone who is sick, come here. Ma le caia basata la basata. Every sickness, come here. God is about to resurrect something upon your life.
Receive
the divine expectation in the mighty is your night.
Yes.
It is a night of new beginning.
Yes.
It is done.
Yes.
I see God making the way on the wilderness.
Yes.
It is done for you and for your neighbor.
Yes.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Yes.
Amen.